I'm Don Hopkins, plant pathologist with the University of Florida. We're here in the vineyard at UC Riverside. We're looking at some tests that we've had out evaluating a benign strain of the Pierce disease pathogen for the biological control of Pierce disease in grapes. This benign strain was isolated in Florida. We got it from elderberry. We tested it in grapes in the greenhouse and found that it was benign, did not cause disease, but would multiply to a limited extent. We also found that if we inoculated grapes with the benign strain and then 2 weeks later challenge inoculated with the pathogen for Pierce disease, that we got protection against the disease. From there we have tested it in the vineyards. We have a couple of tests here at UC Riverside. We inoculated some transplants of Pinot Noir and Cabernet Sauvignon in greenhouses at UC Davis. They've been in the vineyard here for 5 years. The development of Pierce disease happened very quickly within the first year or two with the untreated vines, and now after 5 years, we have protection with the biocontrol. And in fact, the growth and vigor of the vines is still very good. The production of fruit is good, maybe a little too heavy. For example, in this vine here, you can see a lot of fruit. We're well past maturity date, but you can see the vine was loaded with fruit. After 5 years, we have not lost a single vine to death from Pearson disease in this test of the treated vines. We've lost a few of the untreated vines. It is a biological control, therefore it's not perfect. Under certain conditions, you can get symptoms in the treated grape, and the Pierce disease bacterium will colonize to a limited extent the treated grape, but it normally doesn't colonize systemically to the extent that you get symptoms, so it protects it. And usually the second year, the next year, there might not even be symptoms in that particular vine. As a biological, it can be affected somewhat by other stresses on the vine, and Pierce disease is generally more severe when you have other stress on the vine, so has tended to work under stressful conditions. But in general, I would consider this to be a really excellent test site, because I think in the real world, at least in Florida, our vines are never stress-free. They're always under stress, so you need to be able to control Pierce disease under those stressful conditions, as well as under perfect conditions where the water, nutrition, and everything is perfect for the vine. We have vines in Florida, Cabernet Sauvignon, that we had been growing in the vineyard that we're growing and producing for 15 years. And in Florida, the Pierce disease is very severe, very much like it is here at Riverside. And normally after 3 or 4 years or less, all the vines, susceptible vines, are dead. We cannot grow Vitis vinifera long-term in Florida, except with these treated vines. We have some that are 15 years old. The biological control is patented by the University of Florida, and that a company is licensing the patenting and started to the process of developing the commercial product for Pierce disease control.